Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Data Logics with Shivam. Today we are going to dive into one of the most useful function in DAX, the DateAdd function. This function allows you to add or subtract a specified number of days, month, quarter or year to a given date. Now before we get started, let's go over a real world scenario that this function can solve. Imagine you are working with a sales dataset that includes the date of the sales and the sales amount. Your client wants to see the comparison of sales month-wise, quarter-wise, and year-wise. How would you solve this problem? This is where the DateAdd function comes in handy. The syntax of DateAdd function is first dates, number of interval, and interval. What does that mean? For dates, a column which contains dates. For number of interval, we need to have integer that specifies the number of interval which can be add or subtract, and in place of interval by which to shift the dates like year, quarter, month and day. We will go into my working tab. Let's create the DAX function. We will create three DAX, month-wise, quarter-wise, and year-wise. We'll go to new measure and we'll name it as last month sales. We will wrap this function into calculate for using the total sales DAX which I have already created, then comma, we'll add DateAdd function. So the first argument will be the dates. So I will take the dates from the date column. Then the next argument will be the number of intervals. So I need last month sales and I need the sales month wise. I will put the bracket close, hit enter. I will put this DAX into month wise sales comparison and we can see that for a starting month we don't have any previous month data as it is a starting date. I will create one more DAX for quarter wise. I will go into new measure again. I will name it as last quarter sales, then calculate same as previous one, total sales, the DAX which I have already created, and DateAdd, then dates from the date column, then minus 1 because we need last quarter data, and we'll select quarter because we are calculating for the quarter, close and hit enter. We'll put this measure into the quarter wise comparison and we can see here we are having the blank data as because we don't have the data previous to this quarter. Now we'll create one more DAX for year wise sales comparison. So I will create new measure, then I will name it last year sales, first one will be the total sales, then DateAdd, date column, then last year since minus 1, and the year date. We will select year because we need year. Hit enter. Now we'll take this measure and put this into year wise sales comparison. And we can see here also, here in the first we have blank since we don't have the sales data from the last year. Now We can also visualize this data on different visual like clustered column chart. For example, if I will go into next page and will select the custom column chart here, we'll drag here, and then I will use date hierarchy into x-axis. Then we will put the last year sales into y-axis and the total sales also into y-axis. Now we can see that a better representation of last year and current year data. When we drill down, we can also see the quarter wise and month wise data. The DateAdd function is a powerful tool for solving real world problem it takes, whether you need to find a future date or a past date. This function can help you get the job done. We hope this video has been helpful in demonstrating how to use the DateAdd function in DAX. Thank you for watching this video. Make sure to like and subscribe for more tutorial on DAX and Power BI. I will see you in next video.